Hey guys, Out and About Science, Mr. D here, coming to you again from Centralia, Pennsylvania, on another YouTube meetup hosted by Adam Tresca of Adam Tresca Productions. This will be probably one of his last videos that he gets to do and host before he moves down to Texas, so super excited to be here and be a part of this with him. Hopefully, I haven't heard a lot of his knowledge, and he's super knowledgeable about a lot of the areas down here. So hopefully to bring you guys some new stuff that I haven't brought to you guys before through him. And a lot of people here, I'll put down all their links in the description down below in the video for everyone to link to their pages. It's a gorgeous day out here. It's going to be in the 80s. Nice little breeze, hot in the sun. So it'll be hot when we're out on the Graffiti Highway. We're going to go over there too a little bit later. Super excited to be here and be a part of this, and hopefully to have a great, wonderful time today, and maybe find some cool little science tips, tricks, things maybe about Centralia that I didn't know about before. Always looking to learn new stuff, so I'm all ready to science on, and have a great day here at Centralia. All right, guys, so here we go. Adam's seen this on Matt, PG. Got a viewer there, Mark and Orange. Becky, Ventures with Dax. Jamie Macon. JP Videos. Nick's Crossing. Jake, Mr. SmithNet. And Aaron, Revenge of the Apocalypse, and family. I'm just going back there in the woods for something. Check out what we got here.
The ref don't want to come.
No. Well, this is the vent tube, and this is the location where Todd Domboski fell through his grandmother's backyard on Valentine's Day, 1981. The house would be to the right of Steve over there. You know where the house was. He saw the ground starting to open up a little bit, and he came over to investigate it. And when he came into this approximate area there, he fell through when the ground caved in underneath him. And his cousin actually had to crawl on his belly and basically help pull him out. And what Todd Domboski did was he actually had his feet against one side of the hole, his back against the other side of the hole, and he was holding on the tree roots from the different trees out in the area. And this was the nail in the coffin that had the government try to push everybody out of town. Currently, I believe, if I remember correctly, Tom Dabosky is currently living in Mount Carmel now. And he's doing fine, but he doesn't like talking about this, and I can understand why.
The eminent domain, right?
Yes. Eminent domain, but part of it, but his family actually moved out of here before the eminent domain took place. They moved out, I believe, 86.
Okay.
They got the offer, they took the offer, and they moved out of here.
So the government initially, what, they offered people money to move out?
Yes, and they are basically offering pennies on the dollar at start, and people were saying, for that price, I'll stick around.
Yeah.
And finally, when they got the $42 million allocation, they were offering people, they started off at double what the property was worth. And the diehards were like, no, you're going to have to offer me X number of dollars to get me out of here. And they said, okay. Mm-hmm. But in the beginning parts of it, you had a lot of unscrupulous behavior going on by the people trying to get everybody out of here. For instance, say they were talking to you, they come into your house, they talk to you about stuff and whatnot. Then they say, go over to Jamie's house next door and say, oh, well, Matt offered this much, we offered Matt this much and he took it.
In other words, BSing them to get people.
That's the weakest word I can use. But yeah, I mean, they use the old divide and conquer and pit each other, pit everybody against each other. And a lot of the meetings they'd have down at the municipal building turned into some major screaming matches.
I can imagine.
I mean, I was talking to David DeCoke. He was a freelance reporter. He did reporting for the different newspapers and did freelancing on his own. He wrote the book, Fire Underground. And when I got to meet him, I got to talk to him about it. And he said he was there for a lot of the screaming matches with these people, and it got really ugly. The store was over up here. And that concrete slab right there was where the supports were for the overhead for the gas pumps. When they were doing tests on the gasoline to see what the levels were, they were trying to figure out why the gas was evaporating out of the tanks. And they put a thermometer down in the gas tanks, the holding tanks, and it was reaching in excess of 170 degrees. And then inside the house itself, John Coddington, the owner of the gas station, was feeling really tired, and it turned out he was suffering from carbon monoxide poisoning coming up through the basement. So they shut down in 1979 and got them out of here. They got gas drained out of it because it was obviously a fiber house. And that shut down the only gas station that was in town. And it's ironic because when Todd Domboski fell through his grandmother's backyard, he ran across here and was saying, you know, help, my grandmother's yard fell in. And, I believe they actually tore down the gas station around 1982. But they got him out of there as quickly as possible. And I guess they were in the process of getting stuff out of the place when Todd Domboski fell through his grandmother's backyard across the street.
Throughout those woods there were all houses, people, you know, residents.
Named the town Centerville, but the governor already knew the Centerville. He named the town Centralia because it's the center of everything. This is the American Legion, and formerly town founder Alexander Ray's home. And as you can see by the 1840s, 1850s built wall here. They don't make stuff the way they used to. This is where they ended up having the American Legion. They had two different buildings in the American Legion. One of them had burnt down in a fire in 1908. They built what they called the Pink Building later on. And that stood until they started tearing down everything in the town.
Now what's that over there?
That is where the Liberty Bell for the town was. That used to be a bell monument. The bell is now in Wilburton, along with one of the existing bar fronts and some of the benches that they had on this very road. They've had them, they've maintained them and did all the repairs to them to keep them in, like new. And that's also where they opened up the time capsule that they had. I'll show you where that is here on the property. Uh-huh. Unfortunately, it was supposed to open up in 2016, but in 2014, vandals came in and destroyed it.
American Legion as well, and they had it, would have had it inside. But when I was down here about 2014, before it got vandalized in the area where it was at. And it's a shame that somebody had to go in there and try to steal it. But they were able to salvage a number of the items that were in it. Some of the paperwork they had got destroyed and they couldn't salvage it. But they were at least able to save some of the stuff from that time capsule. And as I was mentioning before, that's where they had the town's Liberty Bell in the front here. Attendance, they made a furniture place out of it, and that got torn down in the 80s like everything else did. I don't know what's on the concrete there, but
now, Adam did bring up a very good point in previous visits as well as this, which is that, you know, so many people come up here for the graffiti highway, but there's so many other places in this town that have so many stories behind them, tons of history. So graffiti highway is cool to see, don't get me wrong, but, you know, when you come to a place like this, make sure you get out and you see everything that's there. And make our way down to the old playground.
Okay, so we're arriving at the old playground.
This is the framework for the swing sets.
Yeah, I see here's some concrete with a pipe still in it.
Yeah, that could possibly be either from the swing set, or that could even be from, say, the merry-go-rounds.
There's the other.
Back in the 20s.
We ain't pumping that out of the ground.
No.
A piece of the
back
other
in
side.
The building was built with such wretched overkill to make sure nothing came apart.
Spectacular views. Got a radar tower up there, the church, windmills.
Boy, just look at all those inefficient wind turbines there. I hope they don't freeze during the winter.
What's that?
All those inefficient wind turbines. No, they got a heater system within them.
Nick!
I think I'm gonna fly my drone from up here.
The rest of us. It's amazing, Jay. There's a set of steps I didn't know about.
So up on top of the hill here, just behind where those windmills were, is the two cemeteries up here. This one obviously is S. Peter Paul. It's like North Cemetery. Absolutely beautiful, beautiful stonework, creating a wall all the way around. Absolutely beautiful and gorgeous and very peaceful. Very peaceful.
Way. Okay, some kind of building was here, I'm not sure what, but probably somebody's house. I just happened to catch that from out of the corner of my eye.
Alright guys, so we're here at our second stop of the day at Centralia.
What we got here is
this wall here, this is basically a retainer wall for the hillside up there. This area up here was a sports field for the high school. They had the football field, they had their track area. And we can go up there to this step right up here. We can go right up to it.
Going the hard way.
Yeah. Jump it.
Don't mind me.
So what we did as kids, I was climbing walls like that, down to the creeks, and still a kid, at heart.
Oh, so is that the apple tree? Say this
part. Yeah.
As you can still see part of the sidewalk here too, even the curb,
the main one on the
street.
Just amazing, guys. This was a town, a home. People lived. People worked. People got married. Had their pets. They laughed. They cried. They lived life.
They got alleyways along alleyways. And the, like I said, you look for your deeper spots, those are the, in some cases they might be a subsiding, but for the most part, basically just the foundations coming.
And all that was taken away. Because of one instance. One lapse in judgment. One bad decision. An entire town. Just about is almost gone. It's amazing. So as Adam was saying, he read the steps to the stadium. Beautiful. Gorgeous. Would have been amazing. Nice stone.
I know this much because I took him over where the train station was, and I never got him out of there.
That's where you got to run the train.
Yeah. Well, except these things are full size, and there's about 100 engines alone in one location.
Oh, you're not talking here.
No, I'm talking down on Galveston Island.
Oh, okay. Oh, gotcha.
I'm looking forward to seeing what you.
All right, guys. So I'm standing where. May have been the 50-yard line, I don't know, of the old high school football field here. Again, just absolutely amazing seeing nature kind of taking everything over. But I'll kind of pan around here and give you guys a look. Again, just imagine sitting in here. Stadium's filled with thousands of people. Big game. Friday night, under the lights, or not, maybe Saturday afternoon, roar of the crowd, winners, losers, for the love of the game, and again, all gone. Very sad story, but with every sad story, there's always a new beginning. That comes out of it, and a fresh start. But it's important to preserve the past and the perspectives and remember the times and never forget. and move on best you can with it in your memory. Alright guys, I'm as you can see, I'm in the woods here. Through the trees there you can see there's a little bit of road, and just on the other side there is an old abandoned building down here that I showed in my previous video, which, you know, I'll put up in the upper right corner there, a link to that video for you guys. It's my last Centralia video down here. Instead of exploring that building again, I decided to kind of come off the beaten path here a little bit and just kind of look around the area, and so that's where I'm at here now. And I think I found what appears to be maybe remnants of an old building or something here. It's a really nice big large chunk of coal there. But I say that, as I turn around here, we got this kind of unusual mound out here in the woods. I'm looking down at the ground, several spots here. See, we got some glass, looks like some window glass possibly there. Lots of large chunks of pieces of coal. Looks like we got a piece of concrete here, some metal sticking out of the possibly reinforced concrete. This big mound, so it looks like something maybe that was bulldozed in. And a piece of metal here, some sort sticking out of the dirt. And over here, definitely looks like we have the foundations of another old building over here. With a lot of metal rebar sticking out of it. So, you know, it's those things when you get out and explore everything around you and just never know what you're going to find. Just out in the woods looking for some stuff, and over here, got some more of it. So, definitely an area where there was another abandoned building here somewhere. Apologize for the off-road vehicles here in the distance. But this area is kind of infamous for that. And I don't really see too much more here, but definitely wanted to share that with you guys. I can see a couple of the other people there through the woods on their way out. All right, catch up with you in a little bit. So I went and just grabbed the guys to show them all this material and a lot more here.
A lot of it. I believe we have the collar. He's turning the collar.
Definitely a lot of chunks, pieces up here as well. Top of the mountain up here. So again, here's the close-up view of those big sections of concrete. There's just metal rebar and strip there through the woods. There's another piece up there in the corner. Coming over this way. Nice large pile of old metal and steel. And there seems to be chunks of, you know, concrete, reinforced concrete throughout the woods here. It's a nice flat engineered piece over there. JP is. So coming up through Adam thinks this might have been the location of an old colliery, possibly.
Actually, that's that one road we started to come up on.
Rail? Oh, yeah. There's rail over there.
Cool.
Oh, I see.
All right, so we got a couple more discoveries here, guys. Jake's found some train rail sticking out of the ground over here. We found a big pipe across the road here. Back a little bit and see something else kind of cool over there through the woods myself. Yep, coming over. So we got some train rails here. Something else over there too I see kind of sticking up. I don't know if that's electrical. And you can see we got some concrete here. And a big hole here. So we have something here. Big concrete block. And metal pipe there at the end. We have concrete structure here with some rails on it. So definitely was something here. Some more concrete over here. Looks like we got some electrical things over here. That's really cool. We gotta get those guys over here to look at this. This is neat. And some metal over here from something throughout. That might be some of what that clay is that she was finding. Oh, this is really cool. You gotta come over this way. You gotta see this, Chris.
There's like some floating thing for a rail car or something.
Some rock right here, some cement right here. Oh, yeah.
That's a big the pipe there.
And it looks like we got remnants of a foundation.
We got some rails here, rail. Jake found.
That looks like it was used for.
Yeah.
Then we got a big porcelain electrical.
Oh, check that out. Where's Nick? Nick. The size of that one.
It's intact, too.
Look at that one over there.
Yeah.
Are they free? You mean other than they tied down to something? Big old insulators.
Oh yeah. Huge.
So you found my footing. There's some type of conduit system in here.
And again, we got some kind of structure here. Then you can see a concrete structure just chewing on. From what they're this fine, they've been up here. Excuse me, guys. We got concrete and metal pipe sticking up here. Got some water.
Looking where you probably
some metal pipes.
Aren't looking. And we can all get to see some different stuff.
Beautiful.
Got some more pipes coming out here. Got some running water. Little stream.
Alright. So let's go take a look at that metal pipe that was under this road coming across here that I didn't get to look at before. I got distracted going the other way. this is all about getting out, guys, and getting to adventure, find stuff you never saw before, hanging out with a bunch of great, great people, and just having a great time. And I thank you for coming along with me on this adventure and sharing it with me. There we go. So we had a drink coming through here. Obviously, this is very washed away. No longer draining anything. Look back where I just came up. So, again, if you like adventures like this, like coming along, please don't forget to give me that thumbs up and click on that subscribe button. Show your support for my channel, and to click that bell and click all for the notifications so you get notified when I upload new adventures, so you guys can keep coming along with me. I appreciate that. All right, I don't want to go too much further here and get too far away from everybody. But I'm not really seeing too much more here. It's kind of petered out a little bit, so I'm going to head back and see what else we can find. All right, guys. So we got some other finds here.
Up to the pond, dude.
Yeah.
It's on my hat. So let's see, it's up on top of the hill here, going up to the water. Like a little lake and pond up here. Beautiful. Oh, nice blue water. This is all mineralized mine water. Check that out. It looks pretty deep. Fantastic. Someone's been fishing. Dun dun. Dun 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 dun.
That second part of it actually goes pretty far. I actually may return here in the future just to smoke them because this is
pretty nice. This is awesome, it's beautiful. Oh, yeah. That's all electrical.
Yeah.
Fishing lure.
Even the timber there. You guys are going to be able to see this, but...
Yeah, that's what I was thinking about.
There's a bluegill in there.
I brought my pack up here, but yeah, I'll just do it from the car because we're just right off the road.
I was going to stick my camera in the water, but I got my cover.
Hey guys, so out and about science, Mr. G back with you again, and we're here at some of the vents, again down here at Centralia. Going to check some of them out. Going to head back, straight back through in there, and head up on the mountain. I got my temperature gun here with me. I'll check out, see what some of the temperatures are in some of these vents, and yeah, just have a good day, and try to show you guys something a little bit different maybe that we haven't seen before. Science on, guys. Okay, here we go. Okay, we got several vents in here. I think these are some of the ones that I've checked out in previous videos, so won't go up and show you those per se today, but see if we can find some different ones I haven't checked out yet. I'll take you guys to those. Alright guys, so we're kind of on the mine shaft here through the woods. Get a little closer this time than I did my last video for you guys. There we go, we got Jacob Smith, Mr. Smith Matt, and just wanted the coal cracker, Chris.
And lots of mosquitoes in there. I went in, all of a sudden all flew up. It's solid, you can walk in it.
The leaves are a little slippy though.
There we go.
There's the mine entrance right here.
All filled in.
Nice in there if it weren't for this.
Yeah, right? Incredible. Man makes it, nature reclaims it.
The coal.
It was a nice chunk.
The extra burning some of it.
Yeah, now he's home for a month.
So as usual, guys, more dumping still going on here, continuing to be dumped on here. Hey, Chris, there's an old TV, huh?
Yep.
That's it, you got it. Seems to be more than last time. I don't believe all these mattresses were here the last time I was here.
And unfortunately, as you can see, all the garbage we have a nice mattress we have here going on.
It's terrible, guys. Seems like there's more and more every time we come. And it just keeps going. Sad. But times are tough for a lot of people. And garbage takes a lot. Dispose of, fortunately. Excuse me.
Different YouTubers.
So we're still kind of walking along where that mine shaft entrance was in that mountain. Kind of see where kind of still in this kind of gully area, all these rocks come up from the side. Just poking around in here a little bit, guys. Ah, what do you know? Coal cracker find a coal seam.
Yes, he did.
I can see it from here. Yes, he did.
Coal cracker just found another entrance, I guess.
Coal seam, yeah. Excellent. Oh, lots of nice chunks of coal.
Oh yeah.
I've been this far.
Yeah, I see it. So we're coming down on this gully here still and on the cliff face, and you know, Lewis down there. Looks like we got some more openings in the cliff face over here. Check out. So gonna head on down over there. Yep. Oh yeah. Grew up in this stuff. Wow, look at that rock formation. It's kind of left there, sticking out all by itself. Some of it's fallen on this side. And just the amount of fracturing of the rock. Wonder if this was blasted at some point in here as they were digging all this up. We're gonna get closer and check it out, because wow, just look at how that rock has been fractured and moved and it's tilted to the left. It's incredible. Getting close enough, looking at the layering of this rock, realizing all these layers of rock were formed from sediments and leaves and plant material hundreds of millions of years ago. This area was very wet and very tropical, like all that plant material year after year. Just adding up, dying, falling to the forest floor, just like it does today. forming all these rocks, all this material. And this is outstanding. Incredible. Incredible. Again, sorry for any shaky footage here. This is what I'm walking on. I'm trying to walk through, so it's pretty incredible. Just looking how that rock is fractured.
Don't mind me. I know. I'm trying to get stuff in my pocket. That's even as I do it. I gotta climb up. It's sort of like steps here. And one day that's just gonna go boom.
Oh, yeah. Yep, that's definitely gonna fall.
Yeah, today better not be today.
That seems incredible. I'm gonna follow you up there, I think. I think the view up on top is gonna. Yep, I think the view on top will be incredible. I will see you guys at the top. All right, guys, well, as you can see, that narrow crevice looking up, steep. I put my fingers in some cracks and stuff with rocks to kind of hoist myself up, but got up there. Incredible, incredible, incredible. And turn you guys around here and see a little crack passageway through here.
There's not much holding that up.
No. Some tree roots and a little bit of ledge. Oh wow, look at this. Just this little piece here. Mm-hmm. It's already.
Yeah, and it just goes right down. Come over here. I think we can get down this way before you even
over here. Wow, look at that, guys. Woo! That is steep and straight down.
Wow. You can tell these rocks used to be up on the hillside here, and they just.
Oh, yeah. That big hole crevice going down in. Wow, that's a hole going down in there. Incredible, guys. Oh yeah, the tree just broke when I pushed on it.
Hey, that tree's dead.
Oh yeah. Wow, look at all this rock that's just falling down. These huge, massive. It's not even rock, it's just the side of the mountain is just all falling over on its side. Completely collapsed. I think they mined underneath it.
Oh, wow.
It's pretty crazy though.
Stay. We don't need footage of that.
Is there a way down through there or no? Oh yeah.
Yeah, this is back. I think it went about 4 feet. Oh, wide. Oh shit. Watch it. Oh, it's watching all these right here.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Going down in quite a bit. Nice. Very nice. Oh yeah. Yeah, probably. I think so. That's why I was wondering that way. From up there, I'm like, that looks like a drop off on that side. All
right. A lot cooler, see.
So that's right where we just came down, all that loose rock.
Oh, it's only 63 degrees here.
And we had 80 up there.
Yeah.
That's incredible.
That thing keeps beeping on me.
Hey, Lewis. Still just all fragmented rock has fallen. This is incredible. So we were just up there at the top, and that was why we didn't come down, because big drop-offs on those rocks there, and big massive rock here in front of me, just huge. I'm gonna put the camera down here and go stand in front of that. Maybe I'll give you perspective of how big it is. So, I'm 5'10", 5'11", in around there, and so hopefully that gives you some perspective of how big and massive that is. So, let me get around this rock and see what's on the other side if we can. Wow. So up there is where we were, and this is that rock that was in front of us. That's just leaning. Not much holding it up the ground now. It's massive. Scary though. Alright. Definitely seems that way. I'm just trying to come over here on the other side. It's just, these are all fragmented and broken pieces here. And then kind of ends and kind of goes into a gully on the other side there. So we'll head back up to the main road and see you guys back up there. So exploring the coal cracker, I found this cave on the other side of those rocks, and between those two, pretty cool. Nice and cool and down here. Beautiful. So yeah, I was gonna go back up the road, but he called me over to show me the cave, so here I am. Fantastic. And you never see this stuff unless you get out and walk around and explore if you can. Well, it's just a nice fun day out.
crevice and nook here. Really can't tell how far back underneath the rock shelf it goes.
Hollow right here, where I'm standing on.
Yeah.
It's not big enough for a human to get down, but yeah, that keeps going.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, glasses are slipping. Yeah. Right there, straight ahead, it goes down. Can't see far down. I'm not going down in there either.
Nah.
It's too buggy to me.
Hi, guys. Welcome back. I am here at the infamous Graffiti Highway once again, and a little different than when I was here last time in October of last year. There are many more dirt piles, and virtually none of the highway is left really to see. Kind of disappointing to come here and not really be able to see anything but just some dirt piles. So I'm gonna flip the camera around here in a second, turn around, and give you guys the best view of really nothing.
Exactly. All right.
There you go. As you can see, it's pile after pile. I think the piles are starting to wash down. Some people have painted some of the rocks, but there really is not any of the highway left. Dirt piles, I think, are washing down, spreading themselves out. That's what's happening. So I'm not gonna keep walking down because it's really more of just the same to see and very little. When I was back here in October of last year, the piles were just put down maybe a week or two before, and you know, you're able to still see a lot of the highway in between and a lot of the old tags that were still there. So quite a different story, and kind of sad. Walk here just a little bit. So there's very little going on here, guys. See, some people have tagged some of the rocks and some of the dirt piles, but this is just washing away. Each rainstorm, each time it rains. But not much left but a big pile of dirt. Graffiti Highway. But as the rock over here says, excuse me, still love being here. Still love it as a piece of history. And still love the story of Centralia and Graffiti Highway. And that you'll never be able to take away. I'll make sure I get Mr. Tereska here. Definitely will miss you, Adam. All right, guys, well, I'm gonna wrap this up here for today. It's been another wonderful, awesome day down here at Centralia on Graffiti Highway. Had a lot of fun with a lot of friends once again, as always. Day's not over yet. I think we're gonna head over to Knoebels, but I don't know if I'm gonna be filming over there, just trying to go over there for some dinner and just a little relaxation after a nice long hot day. But beautiful weather today, a little warm, but not bad overall. Rain held off, so great, wonderful, and found some new things to share with you guys today and some familiar places, which was really awesome. So thanks for coming along. Thanks for watching the video. Don't forget to give the video a thumbs up, like, subscribe if you're not, and ring that bell for notifications of when I upload new videos. And remember, science is everywhere. What will you find?